Alright, Adam Antarx here. In the previous video, I just walked you through how the train system looks, the subway system that I built for my city, and basically we just looked at what its effects are. What I want to do now is reveal some of the nuts and bolts of this baby and show you how it works. So if you're a Minecraft nerd, or if you're just a nerd in general, and you're curious about how I made this happen, feel free to check it out. Why don't we, just for the sake of review, or in case you missed the first video, why don't we ride the train? Hopefully there won't be too much lag. And we can look at the effects, and then from there we can look at how those effects occur. Walk you through an explanation. And here we are in a different place. The train works. Okay. As far as I know, in Minecraft, without the use of mods, there's no way to really make a large moving entity. That is, to actually make this train move. So what you actually just saw was us teleporting through several different rooms, duplicate rooms, or more accurately, train cars that of course look exactly alike, other than things that are supposed to change in each one. We'll look at some of those changes as well. What you also just saw, believe it or not, was you just saw the game execute probably somewhere around 150 to 200 different commands, and I'll show you how those work in a moment. And did all of that to create this little bit of magic, or rather, science. Okay, so why don't we ride this again? This time, I'm gonna cut the volume down a little bit in the game so you can hear me talking over some of the sounds. I don't want to completely kill the sound though. Let's cut that way down. Let's cut it down to about 10%. I still want you to hear it in the background. Now, notice that the first thing you're going to hear, that chugging sound, for lack of a better term. Now, disclaimer: I'm very aware that having lived in Washington, D.C., and having ridden on a subway system pretty much every day I live there, I'm very aware that the sound you hear is not the sound of a normal electric subway system. There is no real humming sound that I know of that's anything close to what a subway system sounds like in Minecraft. So I took some artistic license and had it make more the sound of a traditional train, and pistons work great for that. So notice that one of the things, what you're going to hear very lightly in the background at this point, you're going to hear these pistons slowly speed up in their tempo, just like a real train would do, right? And the other thing you're going to notice, and visually I'll turn this way so you can see it, you'll notice that these doorways we have here will actually close from top to bottom. All right, you ready? Of course you are. Here we go. It's going to speed up faster, and here we are. Now we just teleported to a different room. Of course, the cadence, the tempo of the pistons are regular, as if we're moving at full speed to our destination. And here we have arrived. You might have also noticed, if you were paying close attention, that some of these beacons, which look just like glass blocks with a beacon inside, that some of them turn to glass blocks. I wanted to create the sense that the lights go a little bit dim, and that emphasizes the effect of the outside lights going by, which is why I dimmed it a little bit. Another artistic license I took. Anyway, here we are back at our other destination, my underground city that I'm working on. You don't see much on this side. I've actually developed it more over here. It's a work in progress. This is supposed to have the sense of more of an old world type space in my modern city. Anyway, so where to start in explaining how this works? I'm going to assume that my primary audience knows the basics of Minecraft. So I'm gonna try not to over explain simple things like how pressure plates work. I'm also going to drink a potion of night vision so that you can see the things that would otherwise be in darkness that I'm going to show you. So basically, this pressure plate starts it all off. When you step on that pressure plate, a series of command blocks activate. I'll go ahead and show you what those look like. Okay. So a command block's cool. I loved it when they came out with these. So a command block takes basically a command program in the game that you type into it, and when it receives electricity or a redstone signal in Minecraft, it activates that command. So when this receives the redstone impulse, it actually plays a sound, the sound of a chime. And that's that first sound that you hear when you hear that ding ding, the train bell, when we start. This one is the second chime you hear, so it's ding ding, right? Okay, but from there, the piston sounds start. Now you'll notice that I put delays here between these. These are redstone repeaters, but they're also redstone delays. And you can set how long that delay is. This is 0.1 seconds, 0.2 seconds, 0.3 seconds, and 0.4 seconds, which is basically almost half a second. Together, these two, as you'd guess, 0.4 and 0.4, makes 0.8 seconds, which is almost a full second. If I wanted to make it exactly a full second, I would have two of these just like this, and then I would have one set right here to 0.2, excuse me. Right there to 0.2, and that would give me exactly a 1 second delay. Anyway, so let's go. Normally I wouldn't explain that, but that's how I got this effect of the tempo speeding up. Notice when you hear each chug sound, chug chug, chug chug, those are always together, separated by the same rhythm, which in this case is 0.1, 0.2 seconds. Okay, same thing here. But between those pairings, right, we have a much longer delay, but those delays get shorter by intervals as we go. And I tried to make those equal changes. So, if we go on down, you can hear all these are making those piston sounds. All right, and at the very end of this string is a teleport block. I had to give it a pretty big range for it to reach us at a radius of 55 blocks away. What this translates to is teleport the nearest player in a radius of 55 blocks to these coordinates, negative 27, 79, 9, 29, 58. This doesn't actually activate until all of these have fired. And that is how we get that effect. Now, I mentioned that the doors close. I'll share that functionality with you as well. I'm just going to replace this floor as we go, keep it nice. nice and clean. Okay, there's a redstone wire underneath this. Underneath this activator, this pressure plate, and that's what sets it off. Well, you'll notice we also have command blocks in this direction, right? These command blocks, simultaneously, they also receive that same signal in this direction, and these do a set block function, which places a block at the coordinates you set it at. Concrete is just the white concrete, which is what this is made of, right? And so when you see those doors appear, when you see them go da-da, da-da, like that, what's causing that is right here. And I even set a slight delay so you can see those doors closing. Right, and that's 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, there's a fifth one. What's that? Well, that is actually the little message that you see, right? Because when you ride a subway, there's either a person or an automated voice talking to you and telling you where you're headed. I wanted to have that effect here in Minecraft as well. So, just this beginning part is anywhere from 25, 30 or more. I mean, I'm not going to bother to count, but it's a good many commands happening here already, right? Now, that's nothing compared to what I'm about to show you. Let's see. Which way do we want to go? We want to go this way. Let's get about the right level. This should work. Yeah, I put those white blocks there intentionally, so I know if I'm digging through at the right level. Just in case I need to access this, I'll probably make a maintenance door for it later. Probably even work it in and make it look like part of the real build. Because, you know, most real subway systems would, of course, have places for maintenance. Anyway, right here, just to create the effect, this is the room we were in when we were on our way. It'll look more familiar if I get rid of our night vision here for a moment. Okay, looks familiar. So I dimmed it down, like I said before. Now we'll reactivate the night vision so I can show you around. This is an exact replica of the room we were in. I used World Edit to just copy paste it, so it's exactly the same, minus intentional changes such as the lighting being different. There's also one other difference. You may notice some invisible blocks here. These are called barrier blocks. You give themselves, you give them to yourself through a command in Minecraft, and they're for things exactly like this, where you just want an invisible barrier. What this does is keeps people from reactivating. Because there's one at the top as well, from jumping or moving and reactivating that pressure plate. That pressure plate sends a signal down to the real machinery that makes this happen. And I'm going to walk you through step by step how that works. Alright, I could light this room up, but I'm just using night vision for now. Otherwise, it's a completely dark room. Yeah, look at all those command blocks. Each one carries out a different command. Like I said, about 200 command blocks is what's running this thing. We could do a count. Let's see. 1, 2. What's 4 times 4? 16. Okay, so each one of these is 20. This is 20, 40, 60, 80. Multiply that by 2, that's 160. Yeah, 160. And then we have these over here. So, about 170. just down here alone is right at about 180, 185. You add that to the 20 to 30 above, you're looking at over 200. So let's look at some of these. So notice the redstone signal comes down, it goes in two different directions. So these babies are performing simultaneously. This side is committed to the visual effect that you see, more specifically, the lights that you see going by when we're riding the subway system. And I'll show you how that works. So the redstone signal travels down. I created a delay here intentionally to make up for some of the lag time that occurs in the game when you first teleport to a place. And first, obviously, it hits this first command block. Now, it actually hits these two at the same time. So these two occur simultaneously. Then there's a delay, then these four occur. That's important to keep in mind as you think about this visual effect we're about to analyze. So let's right-click this baby and let's look. Set block, right, at these coordinates and set a beacon block there is basically what that translates to. Put a beacon here at this coordinate, right? Notice this one, put a beacon. Notice the only difference is this number right here, 2962. 2963. So these two blocks that get placed, these beacons, a beacon looks like this, by the way, are going to be adjacent to one another. So let's go up top and let's look at what happens when those two fire off. So we're looking at this part right here. Okay. And just for the sake of simplicity, I'm gonna smash that out. When those two blocks receive that redstone signal, that happens. It happens even faster than that. Those instantly appear together. And of course, it's behind the glass. Now, what's the second step? Let's go look. Set block or something different. Notice it's the same too. 2963, 2962, just like these two, 63, 62. So what's going to happen is this is going to place concrete 15, which means black concrete. This is going to replace those beacons with black concrete blocks. Now, here's the kicker. All four of these receive their signal. What these do is on down the line at 2960 and 2959, these will place the next beacons. So right when these are, for our purposes, these beacons disappear, these that are further down appear. And that function just gets repeated all the way down. So what happens next? Where are we at now? Here's what you would see after those get carried out. You're gonna see, and all this happens at the same time, right? Black concrete there, and right when those appear as black concrete, those appear as beacons. See what's happened? The light has moved down. So it's like we're driving by the light, right? That's how we get that movement effect. And of course, you know, our next one right here, our next grouping will do what? It'll do the same thing right here. That'll get replaced by the black concrete and beacons will appear there. And so zooming back out to the big picture here for a moment, what we're actually seeing, this first line represents that first wave of lights going by, that first light traveling by us. But you'll notice we traveled by four lights. You saw four of them go by, right? And that's where our next row comes in. Once these commands have played out, the redstone signal continues around, and these fire off and begin. Notice that this will occur simultaneous with this, right? So that as soon as one light reaches the end and stops, the other light begins. And then it repeats the process, repeats the process, repeats the process. Now that's just the right side. The left side is an identical process, an identical function, except it functions for the left side. It's important that these be timed at exactly the same intervals all the way down. Unless you wanted them to be offset from one another, which I guess is possible, but I don't think it looks as cool. Ah, hey, look, our light's going. Let's keep the light for a little while longer. All right. That's not all that's happening. Obviously, there's the sounds of the pistons, right? And that's what these are. If you have a keen eye, you can tell that just by looking at it, right? Same interval between them, between these various pairings, right? Which is 0.1 seconds. Smallest interval you can have on a redstone repeater delay. Okay. But then between these is a regular rhythm between these pairings, and that creates the chugging effect. Whatever you call that on a train. We get to the end of this entire function, and there's our teleport. And that's what takes us to our next destination at the train station, right? Now, I timed this out to coincide with this. So I built this first. But then I made the sounds accompany these running through. So even though this looks a lot longer, a lot of these fire at the same time. So these two functions here on the left and right side take about the same amount of time to complete, almost exactly the same amount of time, and that was intentional. You'll notice though here at the get-go, there's this sort of weird side set of command blocks. What did these do? Well, here's the message we receive while we're en route, right, just like you would have on a regular train. And these are actually pretty important. What they do is subtle and never seen. Remember those doorways that I showed you? How the doorways get filled in with the white concrete to create the sense that, you know, you've boarded and you're about to go. And of course, we hope that the subway doors close when you're about to ride. The problem is that there's not a command block there that reopens them. I needed a command block over here to carry out that function in advance. And so once you arrive here at the duplicate train, these command blocks fire and they reopen those doors at the original station you're coming from, so that when you walk back around or the next person walks up or whatever, those doors are reopened. And the way that works is air is a block in Minecraft. And so I'm replacing the concrete block with a block of air. And that is, of course, for all four of those blocks. But again, that happens invisibly once you're on your way. All right, that's the whole thing. And you might wonder, what's this? Well, this is the other direction, right? Well, each direction has to have a room like this set up. It's an enormous amount of work, but that's the fun of it, I think. Okay. Now, let's leave here. I'm just going to fill this back in while I'm here and while I'm thinking about it so I don't forget later. Let's ride the train. And now we can understand everything that's happening as we ride. I will narrate as we go along so I can remind you of what's happening. Okay, so here we go. First panel activates these immediate command blocks. The doors close. The train begins to fire up. And we teleport. Here we are. And there goes those lights. All those functions are playing out. Visual, audio, you can hear them all. You can see them all. And here we are. Okay. Now this is our destination. This also has command blocks that we didn't even discuss that basically do the same thing. These were pretty simple. All there is the whistle sound or the bell sound and the message letting us know we've arrived. Other than that, nothing happens here. I think it's three command blocks. But hey, we can add those to our list. Let's see. So let's jump over here. I'm going to cheat. In game, I did make, so to speak, a bridge, right? Where if you were an actual normal human being, you wouldn't fly over the train. You would need a way to get to the other side, just like a real station, right? Okay, so here we are. Let's ride it one more time. Now notice those were replaced with air. Now they're going to get replaced again right now. Now they reopened. Of course I have night vision on so you can't see the effect quite as much, but it doesn't matter. And here we are. Functioning train system. Yeah. I'm very proud of this build. I'm very pleased with it. I'm sure people could do even better. If I were a total maniac, and I may be a total maniac just for doing what I've done already, I suppose one could even make the environment around this move to create a movement effect as well, but I'm not going to bother with that many commands. I think this works just fine, and it creates the effect that I was going for. Anyway, thank you for putting up with what I admit is probably a somewhat boring video, but nevertheless, I hope that you've gotten some ideas from this, and I hope that it helps you out with your own projects. In the meantime, this has been Adam Mantarks. This is my continued tour of my creative server and the many things I've built there. And as always, I wish you the best, and I wish you happy Minecrafting.